Welcome back, everybody. It's a very unsightly mess on many of our pristine beaches, and it's very sad. And getting rid of it can take weeks or even longer. And we're talking about all the plastic waste and debris. So what can really be done to try to tackle this huge and growing problem? Gina Mangieri tonight is always investigating.
We've all been hearing about how bad this problem of plastics in the oceans and on our beaches is. Well, we wanted to come take a first-hand look, and we were just shocked at what we found. On all islands across Oahu, it's a problem that's expected to only get worse as the decades go on if some drastic changes aren't made. Ocean currents bring waste like this from all around the world, and our shores collect it.
This is happening on a daily basis right here, the entire east side of Oahu, and the east side of every single Hawaiian island all the way up to Midway Atoll. And the problem is, it's not going to stop. It's actually supposed to get 3 times worse in the next decade.
What does not come onshore finds its way onto our reefs, even into the bellies of sea life.
Ecologically, the big problem with plastic being in the ocean is that it's being mistaken for food.
It tends to hit certain shores, but our islands in the middle of the Pacific serve as a catch-all for a growing sea of trash.
Eventually, it's going to start affecting Waikiki, you know, the leeward sides. People are going to start exploring out to these sides as well and be like, we don't want to come to Hawaii anymore. In the meantime, we have to keep cleaning up or else our beaches would be just totally covered in trash.
All these beach cleanups are great for creating awareness about the problem, but removal is really just the band-aid solution to the problem. The true solution lies in prevention.
Prevention, like when consumers refuse to use plastic or lawmakers try to ban it bag by bag. Also, reduce, reuse, recycle. But much of the trash that comes ashore appears to come from foreign places or as detritus from industries notorious for ocean litter.
Derelict fishing gear poses a detrimental impact on our reefs and our wildlife here in the state.
Within the past year, he says a DLNR marine debris report process has made it easier to initiate removal after large waste washups are seen.
They're taking steps to be more proactive and responsive to debris that washes ashore, because any shoreline debris is ultimately state and county jurisdiction. It just depends on where that debris lies.
There are some experimental approaches to managing the waste at sea, from plastic-eating enzymes to ocean-anchored trash skimmers that are being tested elsewhere. But it is such a small-scale fix right now versus a garbage patch measured in millions of square kilometers. Experts say none are a practical match for the size of the problem.
We need to be held responsible to stop the way that we're consuming so that it never gets into the ocean in the first place.
If this was an oil spill on our shores, we'd see booms, we'd see federal and state resources out there. Not so much with marine debris. What's going on?
That's a really great question. Like I said, we're very much aware of the problem here in the state. I think one big difference is that during an oil spill, for example, we know the responsible party.
Is there any momentum from the lawmakers, from the folks who would regulate, to try to get those same kind of resources behind plastic pollution prevention that there is for something like oil?
I do think that there is a large push within our non-governmental organizations to work with legislation to come up with that kind of tax laws, maybe to address the problem or create this abatement fund.
We will follow up on legislation that can help cut down on the consumer waste that can make it to the oceans and the beaches. Also, immediate cleanup efforts, near-term and long-term, to cut back on this tide of ocean debris. Gina Mangieri, KHON 2 News.